my channel. This is Sailor Bhasha. And if you are watching this video for the first time, please do not forget to subscribe to our channel and do not forget to press bell icon so that you will get notification of any future videos which will be uploaded in our channel. So today we are going to discuss about CO2 room, and I will try to give you enough information about CO2 portals, how a CO2 room will be looks like, what are the safeties in CO2 room. Okay, please continue watching the videos completely. Let's go and check the video. Okay, so this is our CO2 room entrance. So the CO2 room door should be always airtight and watertight. You can see this door is airtight and it's watertight door. And also this door should be always free of any kind of obstruction. There should not be anything kept which obstructs the way to enter your CO2 room. And also this CO2 room should be protected by making a sticker like that. No unauthorized person should enter your CO2 room, because CO2 room is very very sensitive room, because it's a firefighting, it's a firefighting mode. And okay, this is your CO2 firefighting symbol, and this is your CO2 exhaust fan. This CO2 exhaust fan should run continuously all the time. And before entering your CO2 room, you have to inform which I have informed already. So now the reason that we need to keep the ventilation all the time on is in case of any leakage of CO2, it should not damage, it should not affect the person who is going inside, because this ventilation fan remove whatever the gases which is accumulated in the floor area of your CO2 room. Okay, so now I will enter the CO2 room. So now this is our CO2 room, and you can see this is CO2 bottle. And I want to explain what are all the things that is pumped on CO2 bottle. So you can see this bottle has a service record sticker over here. It got a service record, and it got the marking of how many kilos, and punch mark of the bottle number, and how many. You can see here. You can see all the punch mark, and you can see the pressure rating of the CO2, and these are all the things that is punctured on your CO2 bottle. And also you can see these bottles should be always restricted from any kind of movement and vibration. So that is the reason you can see here each and every bottle has been provided with a buffer, like it's a rubber thing, and it don't, this bottle don't vibrate or it doesn't. Okay, so I told you what are all the markings which is stamped on your CO2 bottle. Next we will see what are all the pipeline which goes in the CO2 bottle. You can see this is the main pipeline from which the CO2, when it is released, the CO2 goes through this pipe and enters your main pipe. And you can see a small pipe. This is your pilot line which punctures your cylinder to release CO2. So this is your main line and this is your pilot line. So in case the regulation is that we need to have a provision for CO2 bottle to release manually. So in that case, you can see here, this is your manual releasing point. You just need to remove the pin and push the lever, so the lever will puncture the CO2 bottle. So these are all the things which is incorporated in your CO2 bottle. One is your main line from where the CO2 gas comes out and goes to the main pipeline, and the other black color is your pilot line,
which punctures your CO2 bottle when during automatic operation, and this is your manual operation of CO2 release system. Okay. And you can see here, this all your CO2 bottle is kept nicely in a rack. This rack system ensures your CO2 bottle is secure properly, and it is secure against any kind of vibration and movements when there is any kind of rolling in onboard ship. Okay, and next thing, all pipings should be free of rust. All piping should be tightened against any movement. You can see here, all the pipings are properly secured. All the pipings are properly secured, and you can see here all pipings with the U-clamps. So this pipe should be free of rust, and you can see a rubber packing over here between each bottle. So this rubber packing ensures there is no kind of vibration during sailing. So these are all the things that we need to check when you come for a CO2 inspection. So you have to check for any pipe loosen, or you have to check for any U-clamp to use, or you have to check for any rust in the valve area, and you have to check for any loose connections in your securing part. So these are all the things that we need to check. Okay, this is done. Okay, so I told you about the CO2 bottles and pipelines. Now the main thing is I want to tell about CO2 exhaust fan. This is your CO2 exhaust fan, and you can see the exhaust fan is taking suction from the bottommost part of the floor. So the reason why the suction is taken from the bottom floor is CO2 gas is a dense gas. It tends to be in the floor in case of any leakage. So the fan takes suction from the bottom side and throw it to atmosphere. So this is the reason why this natural this fan for ventilation fan for CO2 room takes suction from the bottom side of your CO2 room. Okay, so I had told you about the CO2 bottles, how it is secured, and the ventilation fan, and why it is taking suction from the bottom side of the floor. And now I will try to explain how the release mechanism of CO2 is operated. So each and every ship has its own kind of operating instructions, and please follow your ship's operating instruction for a CO2 release unit. But generally there will be two valves, two cylinders, that is your okay. So general thing is, there will be an instruction like this which is kept on your control cabinet. So there will be two cylinders, and one cylinder will open the main valve of your CO2 line, and the other cylinder will open the valve for your cylinders. So one valve will open your main valve of the CO2 line, and the second valve will open your CO2 cylinder valve. So this is common in almost all the ship, but still you refer with your ship's operation instruction. So here our CO2 system is used to do firefighting for cargo hold fire. So according to regulation, we need to have 30% of the cargo hold which is bigger in size, 30% volume of the cargo hold which is bigger in size. So this is the regulation. And so here we have almost 11 cargo hold. So you can see each and every cargo hold has an individual control valve cabinet. So this control valve cabinet has two valves. Again, one will be for your main valve, the other will be for your cylinder valve. Here in this cylinder valve, you will be having three options. One is when the loading condition of the cargo hold is empty. The other is 1/3 of your loading condition, and the third one is 2/3 of your loading condition of that particular cargo hold. So according to the loading condition, you have to activate your cylinder valve so that accordingly the flow will go to that particular cargo hold and the fire will be extinguished. So usually there will be a chart like this, instruction chart for the CO2 firefighting system, and you have to follow this chart. And again, if there is if like this ship is having a CO2 system for cargo hold firefighting, so that will be having a group like this. So each and every group will be dedicated for each and every cargo hold. So you have to follow this chart when you are attempting to do a firefighting for CO2 system. And again, this here you can see an emergency switch box, so you can press it for switching off any blower, fans and everything which is related to your cargo hold. Okay so I think this will be your operation instruction for firefighting of your CO2 system which related to your cargo hold. So the main valve, so this will be your main valve for the CO2 line. So whenever you open the control cabinet, first cylinder will come and activate this main valve and open this valve. That means, so the valve is opened and the line is ready for doing the opening your CO2 for firefighting. And then there will be a time delay between this valve opening and the cylinder valve opening, because we cannot keep both the valve open at a time. So first this valve will open, after some time delay then the particular cargo hold cylinder valve will open. So that is one thing. And you can see in this line there is a CO2 leakage alarm. So if there is any leakage in CO2 line, there will be a sensor over here which detects the CO2 gas, and it will give you an alarm that some CO2 gas is there in the line, and we have to check for which gas is, which cylinder is loose or whatever. And you can see here is your line pressure gauge. I had informed you when you open the CO2 control cabinet, alarm will get activated. So this is your alarm for your CO2. If CO2 the cabinet is open, here the alarm will start warning. This is your alarm for CO2 system. Okay, so I had told you that if you want to operate the firefighting for an individual cargo hold, you have to open the main cargo hold valve. So if I open the valve from that control cabinet, this is the valve which will open for that particular cargo hold. Suppose this is your valve for cargo hold number 6. So this will be opened. So once this is opened, then the valve for the cylinder will get opened. So this is how the individual firefighting for cargo hold, any individual cargo hold will be operated in this way only. So this is individual valve for each and every cargo hold, has an individual valve for it. So okay, you can see a valve. This valve, if the line is getting over pressurized, this safety valve will release and the gas will be out to atmosphere. And this is your time delay. This is your time delay switch, which I explained earlier. The time delay between the main valve opening and the cylinder valve opening. This is the one which activates the time delay. And in CO2 room, we have a bilge system. You can see here. This is your bilge valve in the CO2 room. In case if your CO2 room got any kind of water ingress, this bilge valve will get filled up and you will get an alarm intimating that your CO2 room is having some water inside it. So this is one thing that we will be having in the CO2 room. And next we will be having a weighing scale for measuring, weighing your CO2 bottle. I will show you that. Yeah, you can see here. This is your CO2 bottle weighing scale. There is a weighing scale over here. So over here, and instruction for weighing your bottle is also kept here. Just you need to follow the instruction and you can weigh your CO2 bottles. So suppose our CO2 is released to that particular cargo hold or to any cargo hold and still the fire is not under control, then we have a provision of fire line which is connected to your CO2 line, and this is your fire line, and you just need to open the fire main valve and you need to use the fire line in the CO2 line to fight fire in the cargo hold. So in case if your CO2 is finished and there is no more firefighting media, like CO2 is completely finished, and then the other option is you can use the seawater to do firefighting in the same CO2 line. Okay, I believe this video must have given you some idea about CO2 firefighting system and how it getting operated, what are all the operation instruction, what are all the safeties in your CO2 bottle, what are all the things incorporated in your CO2. I had shared the basic knowledge about CO2 room. For more information, please refer any manual. And if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe. And if you have any comment, please post it. Comment post, definitely I will reply you. Thanks for watching. Thank you guys.